Morning, YouTubers. Today we're gonna do some more dead eyes. First thing we gotta do. Get these chokers on. The first dead eye. Got three of them. Those about 10 millimeters apart. Use this little tool here to help hold the other end while I'm tying these three knots. That stretched out. Get those nice and snug. That keeps that knot from blowing up. Now we can take this out of the way. Take this out of the vise. They use the vise to hold both strings on the far end taut. And the alligator clip to hold it on the other end. Because if you had to do this out in the open, it'd be pretty rough. So now got this ready to go on the ship. So we're gonna adjust the camera up here. And get a rough length. Cut. Counterweight on there after. Put a counterweight on there after. We're gonna fish this through. Yeah. Use that counterweight on the other end. Hold this baby where I want it. Let me just put this up here so it's easier for you guys to see. I know with those flags in the background, it's really busy. That sort of detracts from what I'm doing here. Now, gotta find my thread. This is the thread I'm using. It didn't come with the ship. The cotton thread that comes with the ship is really fuzzy, and it's not very stiff. You gotta put wax on it, and you still end up with a lot of fuzzy stuff. I use that for tying these little knots, and we'll use that in the rigging a lot later on. But when I'm doing these dead eyes, this stuff here is really great, made in Europe, and it's a combination of cotton and poly. It's made for buttons and carpet. So it's sort of pre-waxy already, and much stiffer. So these big dead eyes, I don't even have to put a dab of super glue on the end of it because it's stiff enough to work just like it is. So. This one is hanging here. We're going to tie off onto this one here. So first thing I'm going to do is try to get this from the back through that bottom hole. Because that'll be the last knot we tie off. That other end there will get tied off around the base. And this leading end coming out of the front will feed through the dead eye here. Make sure it's not tangled up on the top there. Usually start at the bottom. Sometimes you gotta be picky about left or right. So you don't get them crossing over each other. You try not to have them crossing over each other as much as you can. So that's pretty much on the left where it came out, so I'm going to go on the left where it goes in again. This is the tricky part. You got to make sure you got enough slack, but not too much. there. Now it's starting to come to life. So that came out of the left side of the dead eye. So we'll go back in the left side over here. I gotta have enough to go back up and tie it off, so that's just about right. Now I gotta get from the back through that open hole there. And this is where we do a little bit of rough adjustments. Get it the right height compared to these other ones. And get ready to go through the last hole. And then with it in the rough position of where you want, do a slip knot. Snug that up and try to do another slip knot. Sometimes you gotta use two pair of tweezers instead of your fingers. Get that second slip knot pulled as tight as you can without breaking anything. And then a little dab of CA glue. You don't want too much glue because it'll run down in these holes and you won't be able to adjust the tension on that slack and the height there. So that's the last thing we gotta do. Cut that tail off. Now, while I'm pulling on this, that's just about right like that. Cut this tail so I can tie. Get that close. Pull over on the end where my counterweight is. Try to make sure those are lined up. If not, you're gonna have to pull on these one at a time with the tweezers and keep stress on this loose knot before you pull the knot tight. But we're good there. Only got four dead eyes left on the front mast. Once we get this one done on both sides. Now, sometimes because these things twist or whatever, I'll add a little bit of extra CA glue in that hole where a dead eye's coming out of to make it stay straight after it dries. So now we can spin the ship around and do the other side. This thing's getting more and more awkward. The bigger it gets. This side. I'm gonna tie a rough granny knot. Use these tweezers to simulate the dead eye position. Trying to make as much tension as I can against the other side while I hold that there. Then release the tweezers and I'm squeezing them. So that loop is about where I want the dead eye. Now I'll get that dead eye in the loop. Just slightly snug it. So see, that's a little bit low. So before I pull it tight, I'm going to use tension on this tail and try to roll that knot up a little bit. And check it again. Okay, so that's pretty much level. By the time I put tension on it and tie the second knot, should be at the right spot. Going back and checking that position before I pull that knot real tight. So that's a little bit low, and we've already snugged the knot. So we have a remedy for that. To keep the knot straight vertically, use a little piece of frog tape. Lightly grab that tail with the frog tape so you can see it's a little low. So can do is tie a little knot in the rope to take up some of the slack up here near the top. You can't see. Use the tweezers to make that knot go up as high as you can. Pull that tight. Check it again. Now it looks really good there. And I've got pretty good tension on that all the way to the other side. So now we're ready. That thread again with the polyester in it. So this dead eye is probably going to lay like that. that, so I'm gonna go in. I always go in from the back. That way you're coming. When you get done, you'll be coming in the front. Make sure this isn't in the wrong side there. That looks good. And that's on the right. So when that one came out the left, now we're going to go in the left here. Take up some of that slack. Have enough to go down and back up and tie it off. See, this polyester thread compared to that cotton stuff is much easier to work with, and it's a brighter white too. It looks better. Okay, last hole. I want to take up as much of that slack as we can. So another trick I'll do is take this counterweight again and hook it on the tail or the leading end of my thread that we started coming in the bottom here. Put some tension on that, get this in the right spot, and hold a dead eye and pull. Trying to take as much of that slack out as you can. There'll still be a little bit there, but we'll pull that out at the very end. We don't want to pull all of it out because it gives us trouble when we go to do the very end. So now we're doing another slip knot. Pull that snug as you can. Try to get that second slip knot before that first one comes loose. And a little dab of CA glue. Cut that tail off. Now, where this counterweight is, we can take that off. Get this up here where we can pull on it. And we want to have a pretty good amount of tension. See, when I did that little bit of tension there, you can see some of these get a little slack in them and other ones don't. So now I'm picking one at a time. Tugging up and down on them try to take all the slack out of all of them. And then make sure it's tight from the other side over to here. That looks good. Cut that with enough tail for a tie off. This is a little tricky here. You don't want to get it tangled up in the wrong spot. There. Now, without breaking that dead eye, another little hefty dab of CA glue. Keep that dead eye from twisting. And we're officially only have 4 left on the front mast. See how that tape is. I got an ant climbing around on my camera. That tape is holding that tail up out of the way. And get that to where it's about the same height as these other ones. And then the last string here. This dead eye. Very carefully cut these without blowing the knot as close as I can. That was a wee bit much glue, but the rope is gonna soak it up. Take that tape off. Cut. And we're done. So, 4 left. These little dinky dead eyes over here, the little dinky ones. They're not part of the rope ladder, they're part of the support that goes up to the top of the mast, all the way up there to the peak. We'll do those last after we get the main rope ladder dead eyes done. Obviously this is more tedious than this process here, getting these all taken care of. When you get to those little ones, then you know you're almost through, and it's funner. Okay, hope you enjoyed it. We're gonna continue plugging away on this baby. As an electrician, I'm retired, but as an electrician, we used to say, one wire at a time. Keep stuff from blowing up. Well, now I'm building the ship. It's one rope at a time. Till we get all the way done. All right, have a nice day.